What's up, everybody? Welcome to Podcast Now. I'm Alex, and in this video, I want to talk about what could potentially be a very, very good catch that shows that Bruce Wayne slash Batman is not dead in Gotham Knights. Now, this puts together a couple different things. This does focus on that one Talon, the one of the heads, it seems, right, of the Court of Owls that we've had questions about. I know I've seen a lot of people in the community have questions about ever since they did that picture, right, of all the Talons together looking at the camera, basically. And the one on the left, right, the bulkier one, right, very much looks like Bruce Wayne. The middle one definitely doesn't. The one on our right definitely doesn't. That one actually looks more female than anything. The left one, though, I mean, the bulkiness kind of already gives off that vibe. But now we have, and I want to thank, I guess, a couple different people. I want to thank Suspicious Tension 19 for tagging me. And this comes from True Warrior, who found this in the Arkham Community Discord chat. And they put together the pictures that we've seen now from the comics, right? So remember, there's this lead up to Gotham Knights where they're showing Batman a little bit more, I guess, a better looks at Batman leading right before Gotham Knights. And then obviously Gotham Knights happens and he'll be gone. But you could look at all these pictures all around it. And yeah, those are the same gloves. You can literally tell, mainly because of that gray, like on every knuckle, right? That's kind of the main thing that makes it stand out. And then you go back to, of course, the main picture, and he has that glove on, whereas the middle one does not. Looks like clear black, right? The girl on our right, she does look like she maybe has a tint, like a color tint to her knuckle on her left hand, our right side, but it's not gray. It's not the same style as what you see from the far left. So is this reaching? That's probably one of the first things that people would say, or that I should probably talk about, right? I mean, yeah, it's probably a reach. But at the same time, if they didn't want you reaching, or like if this shouldn't have been a conversation in the first place, why the same glove? Then I would start to bring in, like, are they lazy where they, you know, when they were creating, which I don't think so, right? But you could say, well, then it's extreme laziness to use the exact same, literally, style for Batman's glove, and then you're going to put it on a Talon. So it's the same glove, but you're going to expect people to not say anything about it, right? I don't see why you would do this, expect nothing to come of it, and for that to actually make sense. I don't know. I mean, that honestly, that's probably enough for me. Now, well, technically it's not. We've talked about this before. I won't stay on the topic too long, but we talked about it for 2 years, right? My idea, my theory from day one when they first showed this at DC Phantom 2020 is that Batman was not dead. And people have continued to point out, right? They keep saying Batman's dead. Batman's dead. He's dead. He's dead. He's dead. What about Bruce Wayne? Is Bruce Wayne dead, or is it just Batman? Because Bruce Wayne could be standing right there. And maybe, you know, will he come back as Batman? I'd imagine so, right, at the end of the game. But yeah, that's that. So again, I would say just kind of combining everything. I've never thought he was dead. A lot of people don't think he's dead. The way they've overemphasized that he's dead makes it seem like, hey, we really want you to believe that it's happening. This picture of the court, which, by the way, great picture. It's one of the best pictures that they've had of their game, of these talents and stuff. But from the beginning, when they first showed this, like, what, 2, 3, 4 weeks ago, everybody was talking about that left one where it's like, that looks, you know, very shockingly similar to what Bruce Wayne looks like. And you can kind of, I mean, even the ear and the hair, I mean, like, you can tell the hairstyle. Okay, the middle person, you can't really tell the hairstyle. But the girl on the right, you could see the hairstyle, like, longer, right? Whereas the one on the left, I mean, you can, I can buy that that's his hairstyle just in general. We see his hair, we see his face in that reveal, the very first DC Phantom thing. So he does have the build where he is bulkier in the first place. Now he's wearing the gloves that Batman wore. I mean, well, what, again, did they kill him and then wear his gloves? Okay, that's the only thing. That's the only way, in my opinion, you could justify that they murdered him and then they took his gloves. Or because otherwise, they captured him and took his gloves, but then he's still alive, right? So if you need him to be dead for this whole thing to work, then they brutally murdered him and then they took his gloves, only his gloves, and they're wearing that just to, like, taunt people with. So I guess that's possible, but to me it seems unlikely with everything else we've talked about. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Make sure you guys are subscribed, bell icon turned on, and I hope to see you all on the next video.